Jazallahu bil khayrati anna a'immatan lana naqalu al-Qur'ana 'azban wa salsala faminhum budurun sab'atun qad tawasatat sama' al-'ula wal-'adl zuhran wa kummala.
Now inshallah ta'ala we're going to go into the fourth response of the first doubt that was brought forward, that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. In this episode inshallah ta'ala I want to, bi-idhnillah al-kareem, respond and bring to your attention, all of you, that the great scholars of Al-Islam have clearly and categorically said that the qira'at can be mutawatir to a people and may not be mutawatir to another people. That's a very important point. أنه قد يتواتر عند قوم ما لم يتواتر عند غيرهم. That the Qur'an may become mutawatir to a people, but not necessarily to another person. And this is a very important point that you keep in your mind. A qira'ah is mutawatir to a people, but not necessarily to another people. Now, by the way, we're not saying that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. The Qur'an is it's a qadiyya musallama. It's an issue which is agreed upon. What we're talking about is a qira'ah. Like qawluhu ta'ala, an'amta alayhimu. Is that mutawatir? Yes, it is mutawatir. But is it mutawatir to every single person? No. And this is something very important. That's why we say Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi and others who have fallen short in this issue, they thought that everything that is mutawatir has to reach them in tawatur. And that may not necessarily be the case. That a qira' is mutawatir to a people in a land, but may not be mutawatir in another land. Let me give you an example. When the SARS flu came out, there were a large number of people who didn't even hear about it, who didn't know what this is, and only found out and read into it after COVID-19 came. But the SARS, its news, it reached haddu tawatur, multitude. Large quantity of people heard about it, were aware about it. But on the other hand, there was a good number of people who didn't know about it. That doesn't take away from it being multitude. But it just doesn't mean that it was multitude in every land and in every single country. And that is an important point. Let's say somebody never heard of COVID-19. 10 years later, they say, I existed at that time. What was that happened that you guys are talking about? How come I never heard about it? And let's say those people are a particular land. And they never heard about it. That does that take away that the COVID-19 has taken place, has happened, and it has been transmitted through mass transmission? People existed, people got afflicted with it. وَمَا إِلَى ذَلِكَ. So the qira'at are mutawatir to a people and may not necessarily be mutawatir to another people. For example, it might be this qira'at might be mutawatir in Kufa, but may not be mutawatir in Mecca, for example. But is that qira'ah mutawatir? Yes. A large number of people narrated from the Prophet to a large number of people, from a large number of people to a large number of people, and it's only in a particular land. And another qira'ah is also mutawatir in this land. So the qira'at are mutawatir. And this answers a big shubha that they throw, that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. Now I'm going to give you the statements of the great scholars of Al-Islam saying this. Al-Imam Alamuddin, his name is Ali ibn Muhammad, Abu al-Hassan al-Sakhawi, who died the year 643 Hijriah. He's a teacher of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. He has a kitab called Jamalul Qurra wa Kamalul Iqra. And Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi transmits and narrates from him in his Murshad al-Wajiz in some places. Quote his sheikh in there. Al-Imam al-Sakhawiyyu rahimahullah, Alamuddin al-Sakhawi, he said, قَالَ مُحَمَّدِ بْنُ صَالِحِ سَمِعْتُ رَجُلًا يَقُولُ لِأَبِي عَمْرٍ. A man one day said to Abi Amr. So Muhammad ibn Salih, he said one day a man said to Abi Amr. Abi Amr is the great Qari from the seven Qurra. He said to him, how do you recite the ayah, لا يعذب عذابه أحد. How do you recite this ayah? And Abu Amr, he said, لا يعذب عذابه أحد. That's how I recited. فقال له الرجل, the man then said to Abu Amr, he said to him, وكيف وقد جاء عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, what about the qira'at that came from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يعذب عذابه أحد. This is a qira'at. فقال أبو عمر, he said, لو سمعت الرجل الذي قال, if I heard a man who said, سمعت النبي, I heard the Prophet, ما أخذت عنه, I will never take this from him. If a man came up to me and said, I heard it from the Prophet, ما أخذت عنه, I will not take it from him. وتدري لما ذاك, what, do you know why I would do that, why I would not take it? He said, why? He said, لأني أتهم الواحد الشاذ, because I suspect one individual who's alone. إذا كان على خلاف ما جاءت به العامة, especially when it's in opposition to what the mass number of people have transmitted, which is the recitation of لا يعذب عذابه أحد. علم الدين السخاوي pointed something here. He said, وقراءة الفتح ثابتة أيضا بالتواتر. The qira'ah, he's saying it's not right. Because it came from one person, or he's rejecting because it came from one person. If one person was to say to him, is actually a qira'ah which is mutawatir. Abu Amr, he said, I will reject this recitation. If a man even came up to me and said to me, the Prophet recited it. But this recitation actually is not one person who narrated it. It's actually a recitation of al-Kisa'i. It's a qira'ah of Kisa'i. And it's actually multitude. It's mutawatir. ولذلك, look what he says. الإمام علم الدين السخاوي says, وقراءة الفتح ثابتة أيضا بالتواتر وقد تواتر الخبر عند قوم دون قوم. The qira'ah becomes متواتر to a people and may not necessarily be متواتر to another people. وإنما أنكر أبو عمر, but Abu Amr rejected this recitation, لأنها لم تبلوه على وجه التواتر, because it never reached him in تواتر. It is متواتر, but it didn't reach him, Abu Amr, in تواتر. Ibn al-Jazari in his Munjid al-Muqri'in, he said, after he brought the story as well, and he also brought the statement of Al-Imam al-Sakhawi, he said, he brought the statement of Al-Imam al-Sakhawi when he said, وَقِرَاءَةُ الْفَتْحِ ثَابِتَةٌ أَيْضًا بِالتَّوَاتُرِ. Ibn al-Jazari said, قُلْتُ, I say, صَدَقَ, he's right. Sakhawi is right, this qira'ah is mutawatir. لَا يُعَذَّبُ عَذَابَهُ أَحَدٌ. It's a qira'ah mutawatira. لِأَنَّهَا قِرَاءَةُ الْكِسَائِي. Because this is the qira'ah of Al-Imam al-Kisa'i. So what do we take from this quote? What's the lesson that we take from it? The lesson that we take from it is that the qira'ah may be mutawatir to a group of people in a group of a particular land. It came to them through tawatur, and they pass it tawatur wahakada, and it may not be mutawatir in another place. Okay? That's very important. Now I'm going to give you the second statement of a second imam, Al-Imam Al-Dhahabi rahimahullah, Al-Imam Shamsuddin Al-Dhahabi. Imam Al-Dhahabi died the year 748 Hijriah. He has a kitab called Siyar Alam al-Nubala, where he talks about the biography of the great imams. He starts with the Prophet, of course, the Seer of the Prophet, and then he goes into the life of the great scholars of Islam, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, and the Sahaba, and then he goes into the great imams of Islam. And he also mentions evil people as well in that book. When he came to the biography of Ya'qub ibn Ishaq Zayd al-Hadramiyyu, he said the following. He said, Ya'qub ibn Ishaq Zayd al-Hadramiyyu. He said, after that, Muqri'ul Basrati. He's a reciter of the people of Basra. Ahadul Ashara, he's one of the 10. وُلِدَ بَعْدَ الثَّلَاثِينَ وَمِئَةٍ. He was born after 130. وَكَانَ يُقْرِئُ النَّاسَ عَلَانِيَةً. يَعْقُوبُ بْنُ إِسْحَاقَ الْحَضْرَمِي, he used to recite the Qur'an in the opening. He used to recite it to the people opening, in the open. Like, it wasn't private classes he had. He taught in public, in the open. وَكَانَ يُقْرِئُ النَّاسَ عَلَانِيَةً بِحَرْفِهِ بِالْبَصْرَةِ. في أيام ابن عيينة, he used to recite the Qur'an to the people in the open في أيام ابن عيينة, the time of Sufyan ibn Uyayna, وابن المبارك, and the time of Abdullah ibn Mubarak, ويحيى القطان, يعني يحيى بن سعيد القطان, وابن مهدي, يعني عبد الرحمن بن مهدي, والشافعي, يعني محمد بن إدريس الشافعي, وزيد بن هارون, وزيد بن هارون, وعدد كثير من أئمة الدين, يعقوب بن إسحاق, زيد الحضرمي, used to recite the Quran in the opening. He used to recite in the presence of Ibn Uyayna. يعني Ibn Uyayna lived at that time, and what do you call it? Yaqub al-Hadrami was reciting the Quran and was teaching the people the Quran. Ibn Uyayna heard about it. Ibn Mubarak heard about it. Yahya al-Qattan heard about it. Ibn Mahdi heard about it. Shafi'i heard about it. Yazid ibn Harun heard about it. And many more other people heard about his recitation. من أئمة الدين, from the scholars of Islam. فما بلغنا بعد الفحص والتنقيب. ذهبي said, after researching and looking into this matter, it has not been transmitted أن أحد من القراء, that any of the reciters, ولا الفقهاء and any of the jurists, ولا الصلحاء and the righteous people, ولا النحاة and the grammarians, ولا الخلفاء and the Islamic leaders, كهارون الرشيد والأمين والمأمون, أنكروا قراءته, that any of them rejected his recitation. Hasn't been transmitted to us. Anyone. لا فقهاء ولا القراء ولا الصلحاء ولا النحاة ولا الخلفاء. No one ever said, يزيد, يعقوب, your recitation is wrong. Don't read like that. Ibn Uyayna didn't say that to him. Ibn Mubarak didn't say that to him. Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan didn't say that to him. Ibn al-Mahdi, Abd al-Rahman al-Mahdi didn't say that to him. Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i didn't say that to him. Yazid ibn Harun never said that to him. يعني no one ever rejected the recitation of يعقوب ibn Ishaq al-Hadrami. ولا منعوه منها أصلا, and they didn't even prevent him from it at all in the first place. Okay. ولو أنكر أحد عليه, and if anyone was to reject the recitation of his, لنقل, it would have been transmitted to us. أي نعم الله. ولشتهر, and it would have been so famous in the books. بل مدحها غير واحد, rather they praised him. وقرأ بها أصحابه, and let alone him just reciting it in Basra, rather he was passing it on to his students, and his students were passing it on. So it was something that was being given on and it was being passed on. وَأَقْرَى بِهَا أَصْحَابَهُ بِالْعِرَاقِ, he taught this Qur'an to his students. وَاسْتَمَرَّ إِمَامُ جَامِعِ الْبَصْرَةِ بِقِرَاءَتِهَا فِي الْمِحْرَابِ سِنِينَ مُتَطَاوِلَةٍ, his recitation was recited and it was read by the imams that even came after him in the mihrab. يعني as imams, they were reciting on the recitation of Yaqub al-Hadrami. In Basra, they were reciting it. سنين متطاولة, years, decades, they were reciting it. فما أنكر عليه مسلمون. He used to recite it in the pulpit. He used to recite it as an imam. His students would recite as imams in the masajids of Basra. No one came out and said, what's this recitation? Where did it come from? بل تلقاها الناس بالقبول, rather the people all accepted it. حتى نشأ طائفة, Imam Dhabi, after that he said, until a group of people came. متأخرون, latecomers. People came later in Islamic history. لم يألفوها ولا عرفوها. They were not familiar with this recitation. They didn't know of it. فأنكروها, they rejected it on that premise. Then Dhahabi said, وَمَنْ جَهِلَ شَيْئًا عَادَاهُ, if someone is ignorant of something, he shows enmity to it. One of the signs of knowing somebody is ignorant in a particular field in Islamic knowledge or any sciences, whether it even be academic sciences, is when he says, that science is rubbish. There's no value in it. Why are people studying it? Remember this principle. مَنْ جَهِلَ شَيْئًا عَادَاهُ وَعَادَ أَهْلَهُ. If someone is ignorant about something, he shows hostility and enmity to that thing, that science, and the people who possess that knowledge. He doesn't show them happiness and he's not fond of them, basically. So Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, he said, people who were not familiar with the recitation of Yaqub al-Hadrami, who were not acquainted with it, what did they do? They rejected it. وَمَنْ جَهِلَ شَيْءٍ عَادَاهُ, and if somebody is ignorant about something, he shows enmity and hate towards it. قالوا, these people said, these latecomers, they said, لم تتصل بنا متواترة, that these recitations have not been transmitted to us in multitude narration. It hasn't been transmitted to us in mass transmission. After that, Imam al-Dhahabi rahimahullah, he said, قُلْنَا, we'll say to those people who said that it hasn't reached us through a mass transmission, we will say to them, اتصلت بخلق كثير. This train, this qira'ah of Ya'qub al-Hadrami has reached us. اتصلت بخلق كثير متواترة. Sorry, Dhabi said, we will respond by saying that this recitation has reached mass transmission to a group of people. And those people are large in quantity that it reached. وَلَيْسَ مِنْ شَرْطِ التَّوَاتُرِ, underline this point. And it is not the condition of mutawatir, أَنْ يَصِلَ إِلَى الْأُمَّةِ. It's not a condition of tawatur that it reaches everyone in the ummah as mutawatir. And it could reach a group of people in mutawatir and may not necessarily reach another group of people in tawatur. Pay attention to that. فَعِنْدَ الْقُرَّاءِ أَشْيَاءٌ مُتَوَاتِرَةٌ دُونَ غَيْرِهِمْ. The Qurra, they have a recitation which is mutawatir for them alone. وَعِنْدَ الْفُقَهَاءِ مَسَائِلٌ مُتَوَاتِرَةٌ عِنْدَ أَئِمَّتِهِمْ لَا يَدْرِيهَا الْقُرَّاء. And the fuqaha have issues which are, that is mutawatir for them, but like it's not known, and the people of fiqh are not acquainted, people of qira'at are not acquainted to it. And there are some issues that a fuqaha consider this to be mutawatir to them. It's well known to them, but it's not well known to the qurra. And sometimes the opposite can happen. Something is mutawatir for the qurra, but may not be for the fuqaha, because this is not something they are into. Same with the muhaddithin. There are hadith which are mutawatira to the muhaddithin, lakin a faqih might say, I never heard of this in my life. Where did this hadith come from? قَدْ لَا يَكُونُ سَمِعَهَا الْفُقَهَاءُ, he said. أَوْ أَفَادَتْهُمْ ظَنًّا فَقَطْ وَعِنْدَ النُّحَاتِ مَسَائِلٌ قَطْعِيَّةٌ وَكَذَلِكَ اللُّغَوِيُّونَ. The same with the grammarians and the people of the language. There are some things which to them is clear-cut, well-known, but not necessarily to the other scholars of other sciences. وَلَيْسَ مَنْ جَهِلَ عِلْمًا حُجَّةً عَلَى مَنْ عَلِمَهُ. A person who is ignorant about something or a science or a knowledge, we shouldn't use him as a proof against the one who has knowledge of the issue. If the qira'ah is being mentioned by some scholars that it's mutawatir, and a group of people are saying it's not mutawatir, we say, مَنْ عَلِمَ حُجَّةٌ عَلَى مَنْ لَمْ يَعْلَمْ. The ones who know are a proof against the ones who don't know. Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, Ibn Salah, and other than them, who say it's not mutawatir, they are negators. They don't have the knowledge to affirm. But the ones who've affirmed have the knowledge for it. And the scholars, they say, the one who knows is a proof against the one who doesn't know. ولذلك عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said, لَقَدْ عَظَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ الْفِرْيَةِ. He's a liar. And he's made a grave lie. The one who says that the Prophet ﷺ urinated standing up. Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman, he said, بَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَائِمًا. The Prophet urinated standing up. Aisha negated, Hudhayfah affirmed. Who did the scholars take? They said, Aisha doesn't know. She's negating because she never saw it. Hudhayfah saw it. مَنْ عَلِمَ حُجَّةٌ عَلَى مَنْ لَمْ يَعْلَمْ. The one who knows and saw it and has that extra knowledge is a proof against the one who doesn't have that extra knowledge. So the one who says that the Qur'an is mutawatir and says that it's mutawatir has a knowledge that the one who's negating doesn't have. That's what the Dhahabi is saying here. وَلَيْسَ مَنْ جَهِلَ عِلْمًا حُجَّةً عَلَى مَنْ عَلِمَهُ وَإِنَّمَا يُقَالُ لِلْجَاهِلِ. This ignorant person who says that this qira'ah is not mutawatir, this ignorant person who negates it will be said to them, تَعَلَّمْ لَنْ وَسَلْ أَهْلَ الْعِلْمِ, and ask the people of knowledge, إِن كُنْتَ لَا تَعْلَمُ, if you don't know. That statement from Al-Imam al-Dhahabi itself is enough. We should stop the episode there. But inshallah ta'ala, to make the issue even more clearer, I'm going to bring you other quotes from other great scholars. Tajuddin al-Subki rahimahullah, who died the year 881 Hijriya. There's a kitab called Raf'u al-Hajib and Mukhtasar ibn al-Hajib. He, which is in the science of Usul al-Fiqh, he says, وَرُبَّ مُتَوَاتِرْ. Ha, Allahu Akbar. وَرُبَّ مُتَوَاتِرْ. It may be mutawatir. عند قوم, to a people, دون آخرين, not to another people. وفي وقت دون آخر, And it may sometimes even be mutawatir at a time, but not at another time. It could happen. That this is mutawatir in this land, and it's not mutawatir in this land. Or it might be mutawatir at this time, but not in this time. It could happen, he said. قال أبو الحسن النوري الصفاقسي رحمه الله. He died the year 1118 هجرية. There's a kitab called غيث النفع في القراءة السبع. He said, ولا يقدح في ثبوت التواتر اختلاف القراء. It is not a criticism, and it doesn't pierce through ثبوت التواتر, that there is تواتر in the قراءات. Just because اختلاف القراء, that some of the قراء differed on this issue. We don't say that this issue, because the قراء differed upon it, يقدح في ثبوت التواتر, that this is a criticism, this shows that the قراء قراءات are not متواتر. No. فقد تواتر القراء. Why? فقد تواتر القراء عند قوم دون قوم. Because تواتر can happen for people and not another people. فكل من القراء إنما لم يقرأ بقراءة غيره, because a qari may not read in the qira'ah of another qari. Why? لأنها لم تثبت. أما لأنها لم تبلغ على وجه التواتر. ولذلك لم يعب أحد منهم على غيره قراءته. The reason why some qura didn't recite in the qira'ah of another qari is because that qira'ah of the other qari never reached him in tawatur. Like the qira'ah of Kisa'i. لا يعذب عذابه أحد. Abu Amr, he's saying, to me, it's not متواتر. But the qira'ah is mutawatir to al-Kisa'i. So that's why they didn't recite on another person's recitation. They didn't recite on another person's recitation because it never reached them in tawatur. This shows you something. That each qari was reciting what was mutawatir to him. Jalaluddin al-Suyuti, who died in 911 Hijriya. He has a kitab called Al-Itqan fi Ulum al-Quran. He said, فَرُبَّ مُتَوَاتِرٍ عِنْدَ قَوْمٍ دُونَ آخَرِينَ وَفِي وَقْتٍ دُونَ آخَرٍ. He said exactly what? Al-Imam Tajuddin al-Subki said, which is that it could happen that it's mutawatir to a people and not another people, and it is also mutawatir at a time and not at another time, or not at a particular time. Al-Imam Abu Sa'id ibn Lubbin, who died the year 782 Hijriya, is a kitab called Fathul Bab wa Raf'ul Hijab. He mentions there tawatur al-qira'at al-sab' إنما هو خصوص في القراء والأقطار وليس تواتر العموم. الله أكبر. He said that the tawatur of the qira'at, the seven qira'at, it is something mutawatir to the qurra, and it is also mutawatir to particular lands. يعني this qira'a is mutawatir in this land, this qira'a is mutawatir in this land, this qira'a is mutawatir in this land, this qira'a is mutawatir in this land. وليس تواتر العموم. And it's not mutawatir over the whole entire globe at one time. Okay? It could even sometimes happen that a qari never even heard of the other qari's qira'ah because of the land. That does not negate that each person is reciting on a qira'ah which is mutawatir. Okay? Last but not least, Shamsuddin ibn al-Jazari rahimahullah, who died in 833 Hijriya. Ibn al-Jazari, he mentions in his kitab Munjid al-Muqri'in, he said, لَا أَقْطَعُ بِأَنَّ مَا عَدَ الْعَشْرِ غَيْرُ مُتَوَاتِرٍ. After he mentioned that the 10 qira'at are mutawatira, the 10 qurra, 7 that Imam Shatibi mentions in Hirz al-Amani, and the extra 3 that Ibn al-Jazari mentions in his Durra, he says those 10 are mutawatir. But he said, I am not claiming. Ibn al-Jazari saying this, I am not claiming, and I'm not going to say that these are the only 10 which are mutawatir, and anything other than that is not mutawatir. Why, Ibn al-Jazari, why can't you say that? Because he said, فَإِنَّ التَّوَاتُرَ قَدْ يَكُونُ عِنْدَ قَوْمٍ دُونَ قَوْمٍ. Because it could happen that a qira'ah might be mutawatir to a people and not another people. As for me, Ibn al-Jazari, وَلَمْ أَطَّلِعْ عَلَى بِلَادِ الْهِنْدِ. I haven't looked at the qira'ah in India. Because it could be possible there's a qira'ah mutawatir in India. I haven't, he's saying. وَأَقْسَى الْمَشْرِقِ, he said. And there could be a qira'ah which is also mutawatir in أَقْسَى الْمَشْرِقِ. And other than them, فَيَحْتَمِلُ أَنَّهَا تَكُونُ عِنْدَهُمْ. It could be possible that it's to them mutawatira. That to them is mutawatir. فيحتمل أنها there's a possibility that this qira'ah might be mutawatir to the scholars in India or the qura' in India or even aqsa al-mashriq. It could be mutawatir for them. So the statement of Ibn al-Jazir rahimahullah is saying, I can only affirm these 10. After looking at it, they are mutawatir, these qira'at. Anything beyond that, anything other than that, he said, I can't. Because there's a qa'ida to the qura' and the scholars, which is what? فَإِنَّ التَّوَاتُرَ قَدْ يَكُونُ عِنْدَ قَوْمٍ دُونَ آخَرٍ أما دون قوم. I'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. I'll see you guys inshallah ta'ala in the next episode. BarakAllahu feekum wa jazakum Allahu khayra.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.